This is Bella's backstroke from the underwater camera view. This is Coach Connor commentating. The video will be shown at 1/4 of the speed that it was originally recorded at for video analysis purposes. Let's begin. Right away, very good start, okay, getting nice and deep in a tight streamline. And then what I really like here is that she levels her body out. Okay, she gets deep enough and she levels the body out to where the body position is nice and long and straight, aiming from wall to wall. Okay, head is nice and relaxed, looking towards the ceiling. Okay, and we're going to notice she does her dolphin kicks very well. A little bit more of a knee bend than kicking from the hips, but otherwise she has the right idea. Also, let's keep in mind the leg separation. We don't want to have that big of a separation within our kick. We want to tighten that kick up a little bit more so it's a little bit more efficient, grabbing more water, okay, creating a bigger surface area. And then as we transition to the flutter kick, which is very good, that's exactly what we want. We're going to continue to stay on the separation. Okay, we don't want the legs to be that far apart when we're beginning our flutter kick. We want, on a backstroke specifically, we want a tighter kick to help maintain that speed and along with that great body position. Breakout, nice and firm. That lead arm is to the top of the water, reaching for the wall at the other end. The only thing I would suggest doing is making sure we have that elbow bend as we talked about in the above water video. We don't want a straight arm pulling through the water because it's creating more resistance, therefore slowing us down as we come to the surface. We want to make sure we're getting that elbow bend so we can lift our body up to the surface as we come through on that breakout. All in all the right ideas are there, so pretty darn good on the breakout, just minor details to adjust. As we see right here on this pull, this is kind of more the breakout angle we're looking for. That strong elbow bend grabbing through the water. Okay, notice the difference. That's what we're looking for on each and every stroke, especially on the breakout, so we can come to the surface nice and clean. What I'm really liking on her backstroke right now is the timing of each pull. Okay. As her hand comes down to her hip, you can see that lead arm at the top of the stroke coming through. So that's good timing. That means she is timing her pulls properly. Okay, having one arm up, one arm down. Okay, as she rotates through, and you'll see as she begins her pull, that other arm is coming over. Her left arm is coming over on the recovery, and as she finishes with the right arm, that left arm will be at the top of her stroke. So that's excellent. That's exactly what we want. And you notice the high body position in the water. Hips are turned towards the surface. Okay, head is staying nice and relaxed. That's very good. Okay, and as you can see from the timing of her pull, along with a pretty tight kick, okay, we still want that more hip-driven kick, but that timing of the pull along with that tight kick is allowing for that natural body rotation, okay, as well as through the extension of the stroke. If we can extend it a little bit more at the top, as I mentioned in the above water video, it's going to make that backstroke much more efficient, that rotation a lot more natural. Otherwise, all in all, very strong backstroke from what I'm gathering. Right there, let's take a look. That's a great pull right there, nice and strong. As you can see, the fingertips are a little bit more separated than they really should be, especially right here. You can see the pinky to the ring finger. Okay, there's a nice big separation right there. We want to close that gap just a little bit. It's okay for the hands to be relaxed and the fingertips not to be squeezing together, but we don't want them to be that far apart either. What I really like here, okay, on this pull specifically, aside from the elbow bend, okay, proper arm position, the way she's finishing the stroke. She's turning that palm over, really finishing with that sweeping stroke down towards the hips. Okay, so that's excellent. Also, let's take note of the knee bend while we're at it. Okay, you can see a strong, specific knee bend right here. We don't want that much of a knee bend, especially if we're going to be kicking from the hips. The knee will bend naturally through the movement of the hips. Okay, and every now and then when we see that knee bend, you can see that hip position dropping. Okay, lowering that body position. But otherwise, on all, as I said, very good backstroke, just adjusting the minor details, and we'll have an even more efficient, more faster backstroke in no time. Thank you for listening and watching this video. If you have any questions about it, please feel free to ask me at practice, and I will be more than happy to sit down and discuss it with you. Thank you.